Hello, this is Victor. I'm here with a new unit in depth. And as I said, first I did the Sisters of Silence, and now I want to do the Custodian Guard Squad. So let's make a look what is this about and how we can use them on the battlefield. So the Custodian Guard Squad is costing 260 points. It's part of the Imperium. And for 260 points, what we have is 4 Custodians and 1 Shield Captain. The Custodians have profile 5, weapon skill 5, ballistic skill 5, strength 5, toughness 5, 2 wounds, initiative 4, 3 attacks, leadership 10, and 2 plus save. And the shield captain have weapon skill 6, ballistic skill 5, strength and toughness 5, 2 wounds, initiative 5, 4 attacks, leadership 10, and 2 plus saves. So as we can see, the profile is very, very strong with 2 wounds and also very good weapon and ballistic skill. They are almost small characters. So they are on this, in some other armies, they will have the profile of a character just with 1 wound more. Even the shield captain have almost the profile of a space marine captain. Only with 1 wound more, you will be on that range. What war gear they have is a guardian spear and a power knife. And if we look what they get for that, so the Guardian Spear is a model equipped with Guardian Spear, can fire it as a small gun, and it also can do can also attack in the soul phase, and then have plus 1 strength, AP 2, melee block 200. And block means that you can try to block one attack of your enemies for each spear that you have. You have to roll more than the attack of your enemy. On the other side, you also have they also have the power knife. I don't know why they put 2 weapons to them, because this is 200, so you use the first one or you use the power knife. I don't think there is any combination that allows you to use the power knife plus the spear. What else we have? They have the special rules adamantium will, so would resilient against psychic powers. They are bulky, they have deep strike, fearless, and eternal warrior. So these 2 wounds, really, you need to kill them too. So this make quite strong. The only way to shortcut and to do more than 1 wound if you have a weapon strength D. They are considered, of course, a part of the Imperium. As you can see there, the Custodians are considered to be part of the armies of the Imperium. So they are very resilient, but the weakness they have as a baseline is that they don't have any invulnerable save. So you have to be very careful of all the weapons that have AP 2, 1, like Meltas, last cannons, or also plasma, and so on. So we know that there is a lot. And they are quite vulnerable to D weapons, because it is a lot of points, so all the elite units can be very vulnerable to D weapons. What are the choices we have, the options? So we can include up to 5 custodies for 50 points per custody. Any model can replace the Guardian Spear with the Sentinel Blade, and any model not equipped with the Guardian Spear may take a Storm Shield. And here is where the Power Knife is making a use. So if you just use the Sentinel Blade, you then can use the Power Knife. With the Sentinel Blade, we have it also here. Can fire also as a bolt caster, and the bolt caster is this weapon here, that is like a bolt, is like a stone bolter, but only with range 12, and have the Hail of Fire, that this weapon have a snapshot on ballistic skill 2. So not a bad choice for defending you from close combat. And they have the problem is that they lose the AP 2 to AP 3, and they don't have the plus 1 strength. So, and only if you take the blade, then you can replace, you can take also Storm Shield for 10 points. And one custodian in your army may replace his Guardian Spear with a Custodes Vexilla. I'm not sure you want to do that. And of course, the Custodes Vexilla cannot take the Storm Shield because, can take the Storm Shield because the only requirement is that it's not equipped with the Guardian Spear. So if you take the Custodes Vexilla, you will still have the Power Knife attack. Okay, you suppose that you first have to replace You can replace for the guardian spear. It's not says anything there. You can replace his guardian. No, replace his guardian spear. So you will only have the power knife. So the guy with the Custodes Vexilla will only have the AP 3 attacks. Okay, so we have to be on the other side. You will give them all the armies of the Imperium are going to be fearless at 12 inches from the Custodes Vexilla. And you will add plus one attack to the unit, so all your guys will be attack three, attack four, and the boss will be attack five. So it's up to you. So how I see that, I think you need some storm shields on this unit. You have a super elite unit that is very vulnerable to weapons that are AP 2-1, okay, because you don't have any safe. Or you have to use the cover, but then the problem is that you don't have grenades, so you will lose your initiative in the assault. Okay, this is another weakness. So really, I think they need storm shields. And now, I think you want to go for a hybrid formation in that case. Normally, I don't like to do that, but I think in that case it makes sense. So you would like to have 2 to 3 storm shields. This is going to be really, they will give some additional protection. So 2 to 3 storm shields will give them 4 to 6 wounds they have first to kill on the storm shield. And then I will put the other two guys with the guardian spear. So I think this is my best combination. Of course, they are going to be a close combat unit. So the shooting is just anecdotic. I don't think it's just when, and most likely you want to put them on a land raider. So you will need to have some allies and embark into the land raider in turn one. This will give additional protection, move the land raider as fast as possible against the enemy, and then in the next turn disembark and go into close combat. So the tactics are going to be very similar to the assault terminators. They are going to be a little bit more expensive. It's 260 points if we put 2 storm shields, 280 if we put 3, 290. So we go to a unit that is going to be 300. But be careful because they have 10 wounds in total. So they really have 5 wounds more than assault squad of Terminator. So they are going to be really strong and difficult to kill once they are into close combat, especially if the enemy don't have weapons with AP2, so they really can do a lot of damage. The weaknesses they have, and it's a big weakness, they don't have anything that can deal with, I would say they have, imagine that you have a strength 6, you cannot have anything to deal with armor 12 easily, and of course you cannot do anything against armor 13 and 14. What that means that if you get engaged by a walker, like the Siege Dreadnought with front armor 13, they can hold you in combat forever. So you will not have any way to destroy armor 13 and walker. So the only way to solve this issue is to put a character inside, but then you increase even more the cost of this unit. So really, for the points you have some strong limitations. Is and one is dealing with walkers with armor 13 on the front. It's going to be difficult for them to deal with guys with toughness 8, like the Wraith, like all the how it's called this, the Lord Wraith, and the other the Knight, the oh, I don't remember the big guy from the Elder, and they are going to be vulnerable to strength D weapons. With the Storm Shield, you will add resistance, but if they roll a 6 on you, they will really make a lot of damage easily to you, and you will lose. Yeah, it's going to be, you will lose one of these guys. So, really, they are very good against other elite close combat units. I think they will really disseminate them. They will be very good against other units, even against horse. They are going to be, because they with the toughness 5 and 2 plus armor safe, they are going to be quite safe against horse and saturating fire, because not a lot of wounds will pass the toughness 5 normally, and then you will still have the 2 plus armor safe. Of course, if there is a power fist or something like that, you want to use one guy with storm shields to try to protect against that. And on top, they will not cause instant death. Even with strength 10, they will not cause instant death to you. So you have to be careful what you have in front. They cannot go blind against the enemy. They have to choose what they want to kill. And once you start putting them on a land rider and trying to move them forward against the enemy, you will have one third of your army, between one third and one quarter of your army between the land rider and this unit. So this is going to be a lot of points accumulated in one thing. So I think they are very fun miniatures. I think if you go for a competitive usage of them, I think there is other options, and there is other units out there that can be stronger than them, like the wolves, the stone wolves from the space wolves. So, but so on, good one. I think they are lacking a little bit of choices. I think the two choices for close combat weapons are too similar. They are they have almost the same functionality. And the only thing I just want to final to round up this, they have also formation. You can take 1, 2, 3 custodian guard squads. This is the only way to include them today on an army without making them unbound. So you have to, and the good is that you only can put one squad. If you put two squads, you have 6+ in vulnerable save. If you put three squads, you will have 5+ in vulnerable save. I don't think the boost of the formation for me is not very interesting. I think the only way and if you put three squads, really half of your army is going to be custodes almost. So I think you want to use just one squad of these guys, unless you go for something very thematic and you want really to field custodes in combat. Let's see in future if they put more units for custodes or different options, but so far it's a close combat unit specialized to kill other elite close combat units. They can be very good dealing with horse, but they have the lack that they cannot deal with armor 13 or 14, and you don't have any option to deal with that. There is no melta bombs, there is no power fist, there is not thunder hammers. So that's all for now. I hope you find this review quite interesting. Please let me know what do you think. Let me know if you are going to fill them, not, and what do you think about the custodes of the two units. If we have to compare Sisters of Silence and the custodes, I will say that Sisters of Silence are very strong. We are going to see them on the battlefield. The custodes, nice miniatures. I don't think we are going to see them a lot on competitive game. That's all for now. Leave your opinion below. Let me know what do you think. Like this video if you find this interesting. Share. And you also can subscribe to my channel. Thanks a lot for watching. And see you in later. Bye.